In the previous episodes, we learned about models, views, and controllers in UI5. We also moved our app into a component, which makes it more flexible and independent from the environment it's running in. Today, we're gonna add a remote data source to our app instead of using the local JSON data. In our application descriptor, the manifest.json file, we define an external data source, which we call YouTube API. We add the URI from the official YouTube documentation, and we know the response will be of type JSON. Notice how we don't include the actual domain of the API, but use a placeholder instead. We will get into that in a minute. Next, we define a model in the SAPUI5 section of our manifest. We call it YouTube model and link it to our YouTube API data source. We also insert the application version and our root XML view in our application descriptor. This has nothing to do with the data source, but allows us to simplify our component.js file, where we replace the reference to our root view with the reference to our manifest file. In our app view, we bind the newly created model to our list control and define the data we want to display based on the JSON response of the API. This looks all good, but we haven't actually defined the full URL of the YouTube API yet. If we did that in the manifest.json file, we would run into a course error. To avoid that, we're gonna run our app with an app router. Let's create a new app router folder with a file called xsapp.json. The app router will be the entry point to our app, and it's also going to handle requests to external sources on our behalf. We define a route with a source, and this route points to a destination. Notice how the source is the placeholder for the YouTube API that we used in our manifest. The app router is going to proxy all other requests to our web app. Let's recap. Our manifest.json defines the YouTube model, which points to the YouTube API data source, which includes the YouTube URL pattern, and the app router forwards all requests that hit that route to a destination called YouTube destination. So all that's left for us to do is define the destination with the actual domain of the API. Let's continue with that in the next episode.